Hello there, I'm PEMBY'S66, welcome to my gaming channel. Now the point of this video is not just to show you various guns from this game. I will show you what I've been unlocking, but the point of this video is to do something at the end which I've always wanted to do myself but never knew how. So I've done it in my own way. I don't know if it's the right way, but basically at the end of this video you'll see clickable links to not just two videos, but to two playlists of videos that I have on my channel. And just basically to show you that that you can actually click on the link and it'll take you to the playlist, so you can watch any video within a certain, you know, genre. And that's the idea behind it. So I'll just show you some of the guns, and then as you watch the video, you'll see what's at the end of it. Anyway, let's go with this. We've got the Typhoon. I've unlocked the reflex sight, the assault scope, and the rifle laser sight. And I'm not too keen on that one. That one's alright on a bigger map, but I'll go with that one. You notice the second strip, there's nothing unlockable for there. Foregrip. Now I've unlocked the hologram. I've not used that yet, but I might use that in another match. Rhythm Works or Muddled Muppet, as we've just become YouTube and PSN network friends. And if you want to check out both their channels, they're really good guys. Anyway, enough about that. Let's go to the next rifle. It's a battle rifle called the Takedown. Now I've got the reflex sights for that. I've got the suppressor. I don't like using suppressor though, because look at the range and the damage. Look how it goes down. Where it goes red there, it means the damage, that's your damage output. So it's four notches less, as with the range. Muzzle brake. Now I had that unlocked for the FY7M in the beta. No. Obviously that's probably the best one. The match barrel, heavyweight barrel. So it's a heavy barrel basically, so when you're aiming down sights, you know, you can see yourself, the stability is higher. Hang on a minute, what am I saying? Well, you have it empty, let's have a look at the accuracy. Yeah, your accuracy. Actually, some of these, you think they're that good, they're not really. Anyway, I'm making a balls up of this. Let's go to the next one. I've got the foregrip. Okay, after that you get the grenade launcher, extended magazine. Go the foregrip. We have the Alpha Jackal. Now this, I found with this shotgun, let's put a sight on it. You don't need, shotguns don't need sights, do they? Shites, what am I saying? They don't need sights. What they do need is, you know, being able to do what they're supposed to do. Look at the damage output. But one thing I've found with this shotgun is it, as fast as you can press R1 or whatever it is on PC or Xbox, as fast as you can press that trigger button, it's how fast it fires basically. So it's a very good shotgun. Moving on, we have the Grendel, which is a heavy assault rifle. It's a burst fire. Now, I'm not too keen on burst fire, to be honest, but it's all right, I suppose. We've got the Gauss Sabot gun. Accuracy is very high, range is very high, so it's more or less a sniper rifle. So I have that in my sniper class instead of the regular sniper rifle. Not used it yet. K-Volt, I've used that, I'm not too keen on it. Scar Mod 2, now that is a decent weapon. You know, it's unlocked at level 27. And we have the MIKE, I've used that, I'm not too keen on it. What kind of a bleeding review is this? I bet you're wondering. Anyway, the LTAG's the next one. The next one, you know, I've used that in the main game, and that, you know, it's quite a powerful thing. Anyway, that's I've not gone into this. Let's go to the secondary weapons. Now, I've got a choice of three at the moment. I could go with a Hammer 2, which is single fire. But that most people go with that one. You know, the Majestic 6, you can use that in the main game, so you get heads up on what it's like to use. Damage. See, the damage for that is not good, but just carried on firing. So if you're on target, you know, it's a good gun. Let's go with a, see this, you could have, you start off by default with the M17 frag grenade. I could have a flashbang, Rex charge, which is like C4, smoke grenade, but I've been using that. It's a one shot only, basically it's an RPG sort of thing. But that is the one I see, I find is used against me most. Yeah, most times something's been thrown into the mix, it's been one of them, the EMP grenade, you know, it fucks up all your cloaking system and everything. So that's the one to get. I'm not far short of getting that. But these other things here, rapid fire, I've messed about with these. I've got different classes, and I've, you know, just give them simple names, so you get a choice of five. So basically, like with the Jackal shotgun here, I've tried to change it about. Instead of auto armor all the time, instead of that hip fire spread reduced by 15% because it's a shotgun. Yeah, I've kept that on. Aim enhance. Recoil is reduced by 10% when you aim down sights. It's all down to personal preference at the end of the day. So if you look at the other ones, you just got to weigh up what perks suit the particular, you know, class you're running. But anyway, the whole point of this video is to show the bit at the end, so I'm going to shut up now, and I'll catch you later. As always, don't forget to comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. This is PEMBY66 signing off.